إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. I would like to begin today with that beautiful hadith في صحيح الإمام البخاري where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills goodness for somebody, He will grant him the in-depth understanding of the religion. The in-depth. والفقه فقه النصوص. سبحان الله، يعني a lot of texts in the Quran and the sound sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And you cannot imagine how much enjoyment I personally find in reading it and searching, and it's beautiful to be able to understand your religion. To be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way that He wanted you to worship Him. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما علمنا وأن يزدنا علما يا رب العالمين. I chosen to call this let's pray the Prophet's way, which is simply صفت صلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And subhanAllah, all the previous lectures had nothing to do with the salah, but without understanding it, your salah will not be valid. And today is actually the first practical lesson dealing with the salah, which is شروط صحة الصلاة, conditions that you must fulfill in order for your salah to be valid. And before we go any further, we must identify definitions for what is شرط, what is ركن, and what is the difference between them. Ask an average Muslim now about the conditions of the salah. What are the أركان الصلاة, the pillars for the salah, and what is the difference between them? This is a key question, because the answer to this question will help you identify whether your salah is valid or invalid. First of all, what is the definition of a shart? The shart, what is a shart? الشرط هو ما كان لازما لصحة العمل أو صحة الشيء وليس جزءا منه. Something that is needed before you do the act, but it is not part of the act. By doing it, you have not done anything. You still have to do the act. And the act is invalid without you doing it. Something that you have to do before the actual act. But if you do it, you have not done the act. But if you do the act without doing it, the act is invalid. Does this make sense to you? You're getting it? You're not getting it. I can tell from your eyes. الطهارة. Can you pray without طهارة? Huh? Can you pray without طهارة? طيب. So, if you do طهارة, does it mean that you pray it? هذا هو. Something that has to be done before the act, and doing it does not mean that you did the act. You still have to do the act. And if you happen to do the act without doing it, the act is invalid. طيب هذا هو الشرط. This is the condition. What about الركن? What is the meaning of the word ركن in Arabic? In English? يقول لك إيه؟ أركان الإسلام. Pillars. Pillars. So, what is the definition of a pillar? It is part of the actual act. داخل في ماهية العمل. It's within the act. So now you can tell the difference between a condition and a pillar. The condition is what? Outside the act. But the pillar is within what? Within the act. We got that? Huh? An act without a pillar, without its pillar, is invalid. You must come with the pillar. You must perform the pillar. For example, the salah. One of its pillars, it's a ruku'ah. If you pray a rak'ah without making ruku', the rak'ah is invalid. Because a ruku' is what? Is a pillar. Is sujood, the same exact thing. فالركن, the pillar is inside the act. The condition is outside the act. Today, inshallah, we're going to talk about the conditions of the act. Of the salah. And there is a consensus that there are five conditions. We're going to talk about condition number one, العلم بدخول الوقت. Before you pray, you must verify if it is time to pray or not. Before you pray, you must make sure that the time is here. If you pray before the time, the salah is what? And we will detail this. Number two, الطهارة. The thing that we mentioned. الطهارة من الحدثين باتفاق. The major ritual impurity and the minor ritual impurity. There is a consensus over this. The other side of طهارة, which is طهارة الثوب وطهارة البدن وطهارة مكان الصلاة, there is a debate. We're going to talk about it. الطهارة. If you pray without removing or uplifting the state of minor ritual impurity, which is what? الحدث الأصغر, which you do what? Wudu. Your salah is invalid. If you pray without lifting the major ritual impurity, اللي هو الحدث الأكبر, اللي هو إيه الحدث الأكبر? Huh? What do you do for الحدث الأكبر? الغسل. Your salah is invalid. Condition number three, ستر العورة. Before you pray, you must make sure that your عورة is covered. We're going to talk about what is a عورة for a man, what is a عورة for a woman, and what happens if your عورة becomes unveiled during the salah. Number four, condition number four, استقبال القبلة. Before you pray, you must find out where is the Kaaba, where is the direction of the Kaaba, where is al-Haram. You must look, أخي, which way is al-Haram, where is the Qibla. Do you do this within the Salah or before the Salah? Before the Salah. It's a condition for the Salah. Number five, يعني, some of the scholars said it's within the Salah, it's a pillar within the Salah, but يعني, inshallah, we're going to go, it's a condition in Niyyah. The intention. So those are what? Five conditions for the soundness of the salah. Condition number one is what? Al-ilmu bidukhul al-waqt. You verify that it is time to pray. Condition number two is lifting, purification or purity, lifting the major and minor ritual impurity and removing the impurities from your garment, from the place where you're going to pray, and from your body. Number three is satrul awrah. Satrul awrah, that you cover your body, that you make sure that your body is not going to be shown as you pray. Number four, you look for the qibla. Number five is the niyyah. Okay, are you ready for condition number one? Huh? Very simple one. What is the evidence that you have to pray on time? قال الله تعالى, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. هذا من القرآن, تم السنة. We brought up this evidence more than one time. من السنة. حديث من؟ أحسنت, حديث جبريل, حديث جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما. When جبريل عليه السلام came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم twice in two days, هذا الحديث في سنن الإمام الترمذي. أن الإمام البخاري said about this حديث, هذا أصح حديث في مواقيت الصلاة. He came to him basically at the time of dhuhr, at the beginning of time of dhuhr. He told him stand up and pray dhuhr. The following day he came to him at the end of the time to pray dhuhr, the last minute that you can pray dhuhr, which is right before what? Asr. And then he did this with each salah. And then at the end he said بين الوقتين صلاة. You could pray between what? Those two times. But we know الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when he was asked by Ibn Mas'ud, كما في الصحيحين, يا رسول الله ما هي أحب الأعمال إلى الله, قال الصلاة لوقتها أو على وقتها. O Messenger of Allah, what is the most beloved deed to Allah? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that you pray the salah on time. Yes, you're giving all this allowance, but by default you must strive to do what? To observe that salah on time. طيب. طيب. Those are the evidence. Now, if you pray a salah, and I want to make sure that you understand this, 1 second, 1 second before its time, this salah is invalid. 1 second. وهذا الكلام يا إخوة, a lot of the brothers, especially once Fajr is too, especially in the winter, when Fajr comes around 6 o'clock or 6:30 in the morning, they come to me, Sheikh, you know, I don't want to pray at work. Huh? Fajr is at 6 o'clock and I have to be at work by 6 o'clock and I have to leave home at 5:30. Can I just pray Fajr at 5:30? Can you do that? لا تصح. This salah is invalid. What is wrong with praying at home, praying at work, huh? In your office, Are you afraid of your boss? يا أخي fear Allah. Fear Allah. Allah is the provider, not your boss. Allah will give you another job if he fires you. Inshallah. Yeah. طيب, we have an issue here. Some scenarios. إن فعل ذلك خطأ. Someone who prays a salah before its time by mistake. He did not look at his watch, or he did not see the sun. He thought it's time, and he prayed a salah before its time. Is salah valid? Is his salah valid? يا راجل. Yes, Ibis. لا. صلاة باطلة. But it counts for him as a نافلة. He gets rewarded for it. But he still have to pray the salah again on time. This is by mistake. طيب. What happens if he does it intentionally? His salah is invalid and he is sinful for doing that. He is sinful for doing that. Of course, we talked about this is praying before the time. What about praying after the time? We talked about this, right? You still remember that debate? Huh? Is the salah valid if you prayed after the time? Without an excuse. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من نام عن صلاة أو نسيها. If you miss a salah because you were asleep or you were forgetful of it. So you, excuses, you have an excuse, or you were sick, or something, you had an excuse. A sharia sanctioned excuse. But you intentionally, knowing that this is dhuhr, and I'm not going to pray. I'm not going to pray dhuhr. Until the time it goes out. Can you pray dhuhr? لا. Yeah, go ahead and pray. But is invalid. Because it's out of its time. But you can go ahead and pray it. For people who do this so, we advise them that do tawbah. This is number one. Repent. Go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do a lot of voluntary deeds so that this will pay off for your mandatory. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kama sahha, when our salah is short in the day of resurrection, Allah would command the angels to do what? Look into what? His what? Does Allah say, look into his made up salah? La, look into what? His voluntary salah. His voluntary salah. Of course, once it comes to the time, we have people with excuses. People with al-a'dhar al-shar'iyya. Who are those people? Al-Marid, someone who is sick. The sick person ends up to do what? Combining what? Dhuhr and Asr, Maghrib and Isha. So if he combines Dhuhr and Asr at the time of Dhuhr, he ended up praying Asr at what time? Before its time. But he has what? An excuse. A traveler ends up what? Combining Dhuhr and Asr, Maghrib and Isha. He could pray Dhuhr and Asr at the time of Dhuhr, Maghrib and Isha at the time of what? At the time of Maghrib. So he ends up praying the Salah where? But those people are given what? Excuses. By who? Allah and His Messenger. Huh? You don't make up the excuse. You do not make it up. Also, Al-Jam'ah في حال المطر. Hadith Ibn Abbas of Sahih Al-Bukhari. That when it's raining, you could combine two salah together to make it easy on the community. So this is condition number one. Condition number two, at-tahara. At-tahara. طبعاً, once we talk about the tahara, which is purity, we mean two things here. At-tahara min al-hadathayn, being pure from the minor and major ritual impurities. What is the minor ritual impurity? Huh? When you go to the bathroom, azzakumullah. When you pass wind, azzakumullah. Huh? When you sleep, Huh? You don't know what happened to you when you were asleep. That's why you lose your wudu. Huh? Then you have to do what? Make wudu. The other tahara or the other hadath بيسمى الحدث الأكبر, which is the major ritual impurity, which is what? الغسل للجماع, intercourse between a husband and wife, or the sisters after their cycle or post delivery. So you cannot pray with those two, period. What is the evidence? We have the Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ Do what? فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ وَامْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ So this is the evidence for what? The mind, wudu. When you want to pray, this is what you have to do. When you want to pray, this is what you have to do. And subhanAllah, this Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani said something very interesting about this. He said, and this verse is an evidence that wudu, one of its conditions is to have a niyyah. لِنَّا نَعْرِفْ إِنَّ الْأَحْنَافِ لَا يَقُولُونَ بِالنِّيَّةِ فِي الْوُضُوءِ They do not consider intention is necessary for wudu. This actually verse, because what is meant here? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِذَا قُمْتُمْ here means what? If you want to pray, then do what? Do wudu. طيب. The other evidence from the Quran for the major ritual impurity, الآية, this ayah, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ جُنُوبًا هي الآية, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ جُنُوبًا فَاتَّهَرُوا And if you are in a state of major ritual impurity, then do غسل. And we have the ayah في سورة النساء, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O ye who believe, لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارًا حتى تعلموا ما تقولون ولا جنوبا إلا عابري سبيل حتى تغتسلوا And if you are in a state of janaba, you cannot come to the salah without doing what? غسل. So this is the evidence from the Quran and for both of those. Evidence from the sunnah, ما شاء الله. يعني ما شاء الله. لا look at this beautiful hadith لا صلاة لمن لا وضوء له هذا نفي نفي no صلاة if you don't have وضوء أي نفي here what kind of negation here نفي what when you see this statement in نفي لا صلاة negation here نفي الذات ونفي الصحة meaning what there is nothing called صلاة if you don't have وضوء that means what you negated what صلاة من غير وضوء صلاة دي يقول لك صلاة دي يقول لك صلاة دي ما هو ده نفي الذات نفيت الصلاة خالص you negated the whole صلاة في نفي الصحة أي لا تصح الصلاة بغير وضوء. The salah is invalid without what? Without wudu. الحديث الآخر المفتاح الصلاة and I like this one because it's right there on the مفتاح الصلاة the key to the salah is what? الطهور is to have طهارة. طبعا like we talked about the people who have excuses once we talked about the first condition which was what? What was the first condition? The time. Also, there are people who have excuses of this condition too. Somebody who has salasul bawl. He does not control his urine. He's always what? His urine is what? Running, dropping. Or someone who cannot control the wind. Passing wind. Some people like that. المرأة المستحاضة the sister who goes beyond her period those are called what people with excuses and somebody who cannot find actually water those individuals for them of course, the first three types, what they have to do is they have to do wudu after the time of the salah. When the time of the salah is already what? Here. The time for asr is now, they go make wudu. And then they pray asr and they pray the sunnah before asr, the four rak'ahs or the two rak'ahs, tahiyyatul masjid and the jama'ah. And then after that, for the next salah, they have to make another wudu. Huh? So that's there. A person who does not find water or sand, like someone in jail, a brother, one of our brothers who is in jail, for example, huh? They place them in these solitaries. ما فيش مية ولا في what they are not gonna pray. They يتوضؤون وضوء فاقد الطهورين. They do the tayammum wherever they can, and they do the tayammum works for the ghusl and works for the minor ritual impurity. Of course, there is a consensus regarding those two, but there is a debate amongst the scholars regarding the second type of purity, of tahara. Because once we talk about tahara, the tahara of your body, the minor and major ritual impurities, huh? But there is another tahara, we call it tahara hissiyya, the physical tahara. Which is that impurities in your body, huh? Khanzir, for example, in your body. Or of course, you know, urine, عزكم الله, in your body, or feces, عزكم الله, in your body, or on your garment, or the place where you're supposed to pray. اللي هو الإيه؟ لا الدم لا الدم مفهوش الدم ليس بنجس إلا دم الحيض الدم ليس بنجس. He's asking about the blood. Of course, العلماء تقاتلوا في هذه. I'm saying it so easy, but they fought it out. بس يعني الدم ليس بنجس. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه صلى وهو يعني when he was stabbed, he prayed when he was bleeding. وعندنا حديث عباد بن بشر ها وعمار بن ياسر حديث في صحيح الإمام البخاري that they were guarding the Muslims one night. And somebody came and started shooting arrows when he was praying tahajjud. And he was so much into the salah that he would not want to stop. He pulled out the arrow and he continued on. He had so much khushu and he was pleading. So inshallah, we discussed this once we talked about the tahara. But الدم, الدم فقط دم الحيض ودم النفاس فقط. Is the impure, but the other types no. لا دليل عليه. طبعا they said the evidence for the body is you know all these hadith that talks about removing the impurities from your body, like doing istinja, doing istijmar, after you urinate or go to the bathroom. This is an evidence. For the clothes, they said وثيابكَ. And your garment purify. And also قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مسألة دم الحيض تحته. When he was asked about the cycle blood, he said to the questioner basically what do you call this? Scratch it and then wash it away and pray with it. Once it comes to removing ritual, removing impurities from the place of worship, we have hadith man, hadith the Bedouin who came and urinated the masjid, and the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the companions to bring a bucket of water and pour it in order to remove the impurities. So there are evidence, but again. We have, I think, one of the issues here that really tackle them, which is the answer to the answer to this question is من صلى. If you pray and after you have prayed you found out that you had urine in your clothes or in your body, do you have to repeat the salah? Huh. ما هو يعني this issue is right there in the depth of this, in the middle of this. Do you have to repeat the salah? Let me first, before we go to this question, I think I wrote something that came to mind very late. Okay. If you pray, I mean, let's go through the scenarios here. And I'm going to come back to this point. If you pray and you have impurities on your clothes and you don't know about it, you don't know about it, is your salah valid or invalid? You don't know about it. You don't know about it. I mean, you don't know about it. Later on, maybe you saw it, but then you start saying, you know what, that was not before the salah. Your salah is valid. طيب. Here's another scenario. If you pray, and while you pray, you spot it, is that right? Spot it, right? Huh? Impurities in your clothes. What are you going to do? Stop. What are you going to do? Ahsant. First of all, we should ask where it is or where is it? Is it on your jacket? Then take off the jacket and put it away. In your shoes? You're praying with your shoes, not in the masjid, huh? I mean, outside. Take the shoes off, كما فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did, and put it away. But what happened if it is in a place, if you take it off, then your awra will show. And we know awra, we're going to talk very soon about awra. Awra is a condition of the salah. What should you do? Stop. Mukhtar, I want to hear what you have to say. من قال لا أدري فقد أفتى. لا أدري لقد أفتيت. Our author, by the way, he actually mentioned this, if you read it. He said pray. ولكن this is not correct. يعني I have researched this. I spent some time researching this. This is not correct. What you need to do is you stop the salah and you get rid of that impurity if you want, or change the garment. And if it is the duration, if the duration of time is long, then you start over your salah. If it is a short duration of time, resume your salah from where you start. هذا هو يعني this is the most authentic about this. What masjid? Here? Then you have to go and wash, remove the impurity. Go to the faucet and just remove it with water. طبعا we have the evidence here. Hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه, he said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم led us in the salah. صلى بنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And while he was praying, he took his shoes off. فخلعنا عليه. Huh? Then the people look at the people behind him. They did what? شوف يا إخوان يا الله العظيم. لهذا انتصروا. This is the reason why they shake the Roman Empire. They shake the Persian Empire because of this. They saw the Prophet ﷺ taking off the shoes. They had no clue why is he taking off his shoes. But right away, take off the shoes. ما قالوا لي ولماذا, why? Give me, you know, a reason. What is the wisdom behind it? You know, like we do now. They never did do that. And that's why subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving them victory. فامتثلوا. Right away they took it. But at the end, after the salah, they looked at him. فلما انصرف, then after Rasulullah sallam actually done with the salah, he asked them, قال لما خلعتم. He asked them, why did you take off your shoes? قالوا رأيناك خلعت فخلعنا. We saw you taking off your shoes, so we took off our shoes. Yeah? Because you are our iswa, you are our example, you are our imam. Huh? لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. Good. لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. فقال إن جبريل أتاني. So Rasul Salam here is explaining to them why he did this. قال إن جبريل أتاني. جبريل came to me فأخبرني أن بهما خبثا. And he informed me that in my shoes there is what? Impurities. Feces or something that Rasul Salam walked on. Huh? فاخلعهما. That is why Rasul Salam took off. Now, here is the question. Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeat what he prayed with the impure shoes? He akmal, مش كده? He completed. He did not make up the part where he prayed while his shoes are what? Are impure. And this is an evidence that this issue is not a condition. This issue is a duty, not a condition. We go back to the issue that we began with, which is if somebody prays and then after he prayed, he found out that his garment or his clothes, he saw urine, the question is, should he repeat the salah or not? ثلاثة أقوال. Three views. The first one, صلاته باطلة. His salah is invalid. And he has to repeat the salah if it is still time of the salah. صلى المغرب مثلا. He prayed مغرب. Huh? 5 minutes before Isha. Man, look at my clothes. He has to pray that salah because the time is still where. If it is out of the time, خلاص. Don't do it. وهذا رأي ربيعة. ربيعة الرأي. That's his name. ربيعة الرأي. ومالك والإمام مالك والحسن. والحسن. The second view, صلاته باطلة. His salah is invalid. وعليه الإعادة ولو بعد الوقت. And he has to make up the salah. He has to pray that salah again even after the time. For your information, this view, they consider this issue is a condition. That is why they are coming up with this. And this is the view of Imam al-Shafi'i. One of the wordings about Imam Ahmad. Here is the third. صلاته صحيحة. His salah is valid and he does not have to repeat. وهذا قول الجمهور. Who said this? Ibn Umar. Abdullah ibn Umar. وعطاء ibn Rabah. وسعيد ibn المسيب. ومجاهد. وأبو ثور. وإسحاق بن راهوي والشعبي والنخعي والأوزاعي ورواية عن أحمد واختاره ابن المنذر. So they said the salah is what? Is correct. Now they looked at this issue not as a condition. They looked at it as a duty. Huh? And you could skip duty and they had evidence. Which was, they said, عموم قول الله تعالى. They said, we have an evidence for this. Huh? ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا. أو did this person intentionally, did he intentionally, أو أخطأنا. نعم. هو يعني هو صلى بهذه النجاسة عمدا. Did he pray intentionally with that نجاسة؟ ولا it happened out of forgetfulness and out of mistake. Out of mistake. خلاص. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. And they used the hadith that I just quoted, hadith Abi Sa'id, about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم being informed about his shoes being impure. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was not asked to repeat the portion of the salah that he prayed with impure shoes. We clarify this. So they had evidence They had evidence for this. وَمَنْ مَعَهُ الدَّلِيلِ خلاص. If you have the دليل, خلاص. We are your followers. We will follow you. This is once it comes to the second condition, which is what? Purity. The third condition. سَتْرُ الْعَوْرَةِ طيب. Okay, let's if you have questions about number two, let's take it now quickly, please. Yes.
If you are in the middle of salat and you find out that you forgot to do wudu.
Forgot to do what?
Wudu.
Forgot to do wudu?
Yes.
Okay.
So you had wudu, you prayed, and then in the middle of the salat you find out that you did not do. Do you have to go and do wudu, or you have to continue?
Continue what? The salah?
Yes.
Is that, ya Sheikh? How is that? Shake my hand, please. How is that? لا صلاة بغير طهور. There is no salah من غير طهور. True? No salah. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا صلاة بغير طهور. Yeah. You could work out, but you still have to go make wudu.
I understand.
I just tried to be funny, okay?
Yeah.
Don't take it personal.
No.
All right. Okay, here you go. المني ليس بنجس باتفاق. المني, the sperm. شوف, we have المذي والودي والمني. And we explain this في كتاب الطهار. المني is not impure. If you pray with many, your salah is valid. But Aisha radiallahu anha told us that she used to remove it from the garment of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you must, if you see it, you should remove it. But if you pray with it, your salah is valid. Fadl. Our brother is asking about somebody who prayed, let's say, Maghrib, and he did wudu and he wiped over his khuf. Then at the time of the Isha, he remembered that he wore his khuffain, socks, whatever it is, not on a state of wudu. He has to repeat Salatul Maghrib because the Salah is invalid. One of the conditions for wearing the Khuffain that you must wear them on a state of Tahara. If you wear them not in a state of Tahara, you cannot wipe on them. You have to take them off and wash. Faddal ya Mukhtar. Our brother is asking, if you are invited to somebody's house, should you ask what kind of meat they are offering you? Because I think he's hinting that you have to make wudu after eating what kind of meat? Camel meat. I mean, let's say this, if somebody who lives in America, what his chances of providing, offering you camel meat? I think the only place that you can find camel meat is in the Somali gang, you know, somewhere. I had it in Columbus, by the way. They took me to a place there in Columbus. Remember we had camel meat in Columbus? There's a man, camel meat in America? What's going on? Where do you get the camels from? Of course, if you are in the Bedouin, of course I would ask. Huh? But if you're in a place like this, yeah, I doubt it. But if you want to verify, go ahead and ask. I mean, I have never seen a camel in America. Have you seen a camel? I mean, I didn't see one. There are camels in America?
Yes.
What zoo? No, in real life. No, real life. Real life, there are camels?
Wild camels in
they have
Arizona? Arizona. I never seen any in America. So. Okay. Are we ready for condition number three?
Yes.
تفضل.
Okay. If you are imam, so
you. I am an imam. Okay. All right. Our brother is asking if you are an imam leading the salah, and after leading the salah two rak'ahs, and then, man, I don't have wudu. That's how it goes, right? Normally, shaitan will let you pray two rak'ahs, and then he will remind you, and he will tell you, I got you. What are you going to do now? Are you gonna tell everybody that he did not have wudu? What are you gonna do? Huh? Are you gonna fear me or fear Allah now? What are you gonna do? Huh? It's a test, you know. Subhanallah. So many times it happened to me. But أخي, Subhanallah. من هم أفضل منا؟ والله فعلوها. والله أنا قرأت عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه على المنبر. بالرغم إنه مش شرط نزل راح توضى. على المنبر. ف right away you look behind and that is why it is always recommended that the people who are behind the imam are the people who are most qualified to lead the salah. He would grab the hand of somebody, lead, you go make wudu, come back. But you don't come back to be an imam. خلاص, you're done with the imam. You pray imamed. You become imamed. Yeah.
When you prayed, for instance, to Turaka and you're not imam, and your tahara is, you know, gone, south, and you go to make a tahara, right? When you come to the salah, what do? You start over again?
No, you're gonna have to. If there is a jama'ah, with the jama'ah, you have to start over for you, and you're gonna make up whatever you missed from the jama'ah. You're not gonna resume. You resume if you're praying by yourself. هذا هو الصح. You know what resume is? You like, you cannot say, okay, I prayed a rak'ah with the jama'ah, they are in the fourth rak'ah, so I missed two and I caught one. You don't do this. You just start over with the jama'ah. If you're by yourself and the duration of time is very close, you take on from there. You carry on from the time that you left. Huh. Shall we continue? Condition three. We have five conditions. Condition number three, ستر العورة. And there is a great debate amongst the scholars whether العورة is a condition or not. Because quite frankly, there is no evidence that says this. And الإمام الشوكاني رحمه الله في نيل الأوطار يعني قال بهذا. طيب, what is the عورة of a man? ما هي عورة الرجل؟ حديث عمرو بن شعيب عن أبيه عن جده, وجده هو عبد الله ابن عمرو ابن العاص رضي الله عنهما, والحديث في سنن أبي داود, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما بين السرة والركبة عورة. Between the navel and the knee is a عورة. For who? For the man, not for the woman. Huh? For the man. طيب. Add to this, نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يصلي الرجل في الثوب الواحد ليس على عاتقه منه شيء. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم banned us from praying exposing our shoulders. So now from those two, we know that the awra of a man in the salah is the shoulders down and the navel till the knees. Of course, there are certain conditions for the garment that a man should wear. That garment should not, in a way, be transparent that you see underneath it. يعني بعض الإخوة, بعض الناس يأتي للصلاة. Sometimes a person would come to the salah and, you know, you could see through his clothes. We are banned from doing this. Also, it should not be so tied that actually sprint out your private parts. Your private parts. That is why pants, we have to be careful with pants. It cannot be so uptight in a way that when you prostrate, when you bow down, people could see your private part. Just, you know, from behind, I mean, covered, yes, but it's printed out in front of everybody. So we're banned from doing this. But if he prays, his salah is correct. With this one, his salah is correct, but it is disliked. It is disliked. طيب, this is for the man. What about the women? المرأة كلها عورة إلا الوجه والكفين. All of the women is عورة, except the hands and the face. هذا. يعني والأدلة ثابتة على ذلك. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, والحديث في سنن أبي داود, لا يقبل الله صلاة حائض بغير خمار. الله سبحانه وتعالى will not accept a salah from a woman who reached the age of puberty because of she has her cycle without what? الخمار, without covering her hair and basically her face. Two issues here that we have is an issue that always brings basically attention. What happens if a sister is praying and while she is praying, some of her body parts showing, like here, you know, we said that اليدين and الوجه. Her salah is valid as long as it's not what? An extended duration of time. And she can carry on praying. طيب. We have an issue regarding the feet. What is the ruling regarding the feet? Do the feet of the women have to be covered in the salah? ظهر القدم, yes. ظهر القدم. اللي هو الايه؟ لا, right there. Show me your feet. هذا هو. This has to be covered. The back. The lower, if it exposed, that's fine. But ظهر القدم. طيب, does this mean that the woman has to wear sharab, يعني socks? Does she have to wear socks? Does this, I'm asking you, come on, answer me. Does it have to wear socks? No. Her garment long enough to cover the back of her foot or feet. But she does not have to wear socks. Because some sisters would come say, you want me to wear socks all the time? No, you don't have to wear socks, sister. Just prepare a garment for salah at home. Like you have a garment for khuruj, for going out, a garment for wedding, a garment for, make a garment for a salah that is long enough that covers what? The back of your feet. Now, a warning to the brothers, even if you're praying by yourself at home, you must cover your awra, because a lot of the brothers, they think that covering the awra has to do with others looking at you. لا. Rather, if you are praying at home and you're seeing your awra, this salah is invalid and you have to cover your awra. As a matter of fact, if you know that if you look, you're going to see your awra, say, I'm not going to look. It's still invalid. هذه العورة من رب العالمين. فستر العورة is a condition. Shoulders. Our brother is asking about بسموها الحملات بسموها إيه؟ لا ينفع. No, it has to be covered. العاتقين has to be covered.
In the book it says thigh, but I don't know if that's a misprint.
It says what?
Thigh.
Huh? ما هو احنا قلنا from the knee. Okay. Well, what is the knee? So what is the thigh? You see? It's between, inshallah. No, the shoulder about the hadith is another hadith. I don't think he quoted it. I don't think the author quoted it. The hadith is authentic. The Prophet ﷺ says, هذا قول ابن عمر نهى الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يصلي الرجل في الثوب الواحد ليس على عاتقه منه شيء. That you have to cover your shoulders. فضل.
Is that condition only on salat or is that also like
on salat? This on salat, but the awra of the man is from the navel down till the knees. Let me just finish this point and then we'll take the questions. Let me finish, Hajj Ahmed. I'm not going to make an exception for you. Okay, go ahead. I'll make exception for you. Go ahead.
I see here now, our brother likes this. They wear short pants.
No.
What is that? When they pray, completely
gone. No. Our brother is asking a very interesting question. That a lot of the brothers, they come to the masjid wearing shorts. Of course, if these shorts are covering the knee, because the knee is part of the awra, nobody can speak to you. But you are at the edge. And you are at the edge. And I really look at it from another issue, that you're coming to the house of Allah. يَا بَنِي آدَمَ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ Masjid. Take your zina. You're coming to the house of Allah. You know when you go to a house of a friend of yours that you love, what do you do? Huh? What do you do? You sit in front of the mirror and you do this and do that. You could spend 15, 20 minutes just to get ready. You're coming to the house of Allah. Witi ammi shortun wa yalla rahman shrahan jamal. بعدين هذا المسجد يعني شعيرة شعيرة الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من it's a sign of righteousness and piety by the way that you glorify Allah's rituals قل يا سلام أنا رايح أصلي في بيت الله ها مع المسلمين أرتدي ألبس But according to the law, we cannot say anything to them, Hajj Ahmed. I'm sorry, we can't. We cannot. But he actually brought up another issue which is important. That a lot of the brothers, they bring these shorts right on the knee. But when you bend to do your ruku'ah, or when you go into the sujood, what is going to happen? So your awra will be exposed. So at least allow a couple of inches below the knee, please. Yani if we can ask you, can. That's the only thing that we can request of them. Actually, I have seen, and alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I don't know if it's a blessing or yani, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you, Arab. Something that I really hate to see in the masajid, and I see it. Brothers who come into the masjid, And they wear these very tight t-shirts and very short. And when they go into ruku' and sujood, they're saw'ah shoes. يعني it's disgusting. يعني somebody is bowing down and prostrating in front of you and you have to look at his back, his rear. Because the pants goes down and I mean, come on brothers, I mean, Huh? We should honor the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, I have a mas'ala here. No, let me see Ijaz. Okay, our brother is asking about wearing clothes below the ankle in the salah. It does not invalidate the salah. But this person is what? Sinful. And he must stop that. But it does not invalidate the salah. And that's the beauty, by the way, of studying the conditions of the salah, the pillars of the salah. Huh? This is a This is why it's, because a lot of people, they think, oh, he's wearing this, this salah is invalid. لا يا حبيب, it's valid salah. But he is sinful for doing this. Haji Ahmed.
Another thing we didn't correct up to now.
Which is, I did not correct, so you're...
No, we didn't correct outside.
We or I?
We.
Okay, go ahead.
Imam, when he was in Ruku, he said, Allahu Akbar, when he came, until Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, when he reached that area, when he made tashahhud, they didn't wake up people. The increasing, what's that? What
I think they do, they are not following with the Imam.
No.
Okay. I see this, and Subhanallah, it's really bad. إنما جعل الإمام ليؤتم به. فإذا ركع فا التعقيب والسرعة. التعقيب والسرعة. When the Imam does the ركوع, do ركوع. Right after the Imam. A lot of the brothers when they are in state of sujood, oh, I want to make du'a. And he would what? Spend maybe 5, 10, 15 seconds after the Imam. And he's what? Thinking that he's doing something good. That is bad. You're supposed actually to follow the Imam. No, I have to finish this. Now you want to stop me asking questions and you tell me I have to stop? So you took away my time. Now you want me to stop?
You have 10
minutes. 10 minutes. Okay. ما حكم, what is the ruling regarding somebody whose awrah got uncovered during the salah unintentionally, without an intention? What should he do? Cover it if possible right away. He has to cover it if possible right away and his salah is valid. But here is a very interesting question. What the person who does not have any clothes has to do? Imagine you're naked, no clothes at all. What should you do? Huh? اسمع قول العلماء في هذا. I love this. لا تسقط عنه الصلاة. He has to pray, and he has to pray on time. ما تسمع يا أحمد, اصبر 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 يا أحمد اصبر. But he must strive to find something to cover his awrah, even if it is a garment that is stained with impurity or a silk garment. Men should wear silk? Haram. But you could wear silk to cover your awrah, to pray. So you look around, piece of dirt somewhere, nothing. Do like Adam alayhi salam and his wife when they grabbed what? The leaves. Nothing. Then, اختلفوا في كيفية الصلاة. The scholars differed regarding how should this person praise. They said this. If he is completely naked, it is recommended to pray sitting down, because this will lead to him what? Covering his private parts. And if he is sitting down, is actually a lot better. And this is the view of Imam Abi Hanifa rahimahullah wal Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. وزادوا, and they actually added to this that he should not make ruku' or sujood. He should does the ruku' and the sujood with his what? With his eyes. Because when you do ruku' and sujood, your awrah will what? So, sitting down. بل استحبوا, they said it is recommended أن يومئ في الركوع والسجود لأنه أستر, because it will veil them. الإمام مالك والإمام الشافعي, they said he prays standing. No problem. He can pray standing. The question here, should he repeat the salah if he finds a garment afterwards? Huh? لا يعيد الصلاة. he should not repeat the salah because he prayed.
How about if he use a dark place?
That's another thing. بإذن الله تعالى فقه الصيام. We're going to start فقه الصيام بإذن الله تعالى. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.